This week is Homeless Awareness Week in Hawaii. LA Times journalist Steve Lopez is in the islands to speak with homeless advocates. He stopped by our KHON2 newsroom for a preview of his visit. Lopez, whose award-winning book, The Soloist, was turned into a movie, says he was surprised at the number of people living on Hawaii's streets. He says the number one question he gets asked has to do with homeless beggars.
Your dollar is not going to change this person's life. Save up your dollars. Find an agency, a nonprofit that does good work in reaching out.
And he says the lack of affordable housing is one of the big contributors to homelessness. So what's being done to help get people off the streets? Bridget Namata goes beyond the headlines to find out. Bridget.
Well, Marissa, most people know IHS, or the Institute for Human Services, as a homeless shelter. But when I went to find out what the nonprofit is doing about Hawaii's homeless situation, I learned its mission goes beyond providing a temporary place to live.
Oh, it's very difficult, very. It's a everyday struggle and battle.
Deja Lynn used to live in Kaneohe. Unable to afford rent or find a job, she now calls the sidewalk her home.
Ultimate goal is to get a job and get my husband and I off of the streets.
So we all have this stereotype of what homelessness is. It's that guy on the side of the street who's living with a shopping cart, who's mentally ill. But in reality, those were just about maybe a third of actual homeless amongst all the homeless population.
IHS says a growing number of local families is seeking shelter. The agency houses up to 50 families in its family shelter dorm.
They experience homelessness where minimum wage just was not conducive enough to supporting a lifestyle. Mom and dad both working full-time here, and they can't even afford home.
IHS's goal is to give these families enough resources to get them back on their feet. They offer classes to help families build financial savings. They work on qualifying clients for subsidy programs to get them housed. And a rooftop garden teaches clients self-sufficiency and responsibility. IHS says the average length of stay for families in city shelters is 196 days. At IHS, it's 97 days.
But once the family leaves the shelter, the help doesn't end there. With little to no belongings, the families aren't fully equipped to get back on their feet.
IHS recently started a thrift shop that clients can shop from. Anyone can donate items directly to the agency.
Actually, it establishes a sense of hope in a world where they're losing personal things and they can then reclaim something that's theirs once again.
In the meantime, while Deja Lynn works on finding a job.
Yeah, we've been looking, and we go to Starbucks. We use my husband's phone to catch Wi-Fi so we can apply online for jobs. Yeah, because, you know, everything nowadays is all technology, so.
She's grateful to know her family can get help.
You know, nobody's perfect. We're all human. We all make mistakes.
Deja Lynn tells me there are about 500 homeless families living in Kaka'ako. She says she's looking to get her family into shelter while they rebuild their life. Bridget Namata, KHON2 News.